Hello, we are back, and today we are going to solve this equation. And notice that here we actually have a power series, and in fact, this equation has infinitely many answers. But it's okay, because we are just going to find the biggest one. And as always, please pause the video and try it first. And you should try it too. Have a look. You got it? All right. So now, here is how we are going to do it. I will show you guys two ways. The first way is the real way. The second way is the non-real way, right? Ideally speaking, if we can find the function that this is representing, then we can just solve the equation regularly, right? So do we know a function that has the power series being equal to that? Do you have any ideas? Cosine x? All right, let me just write down the cosine x right here for you guys. If we have cosine x, its power series centered at 0 is 1 minus x squared over 2 factorial, and then plus x to the 4th power over 4 factorial, and then minus x to the 6th power over 6 factorial, and so on, so on, so on. Great, thank you. However, though, we want the powers to be 1, 2, 3. You see? So what can we do next? Well, as long as we can divide the powers by 2, then we can achieve that. And the way to do is, just look at the x as square root of x. Have a look. I'm just going to write cosine, but I will actually invite the square root to help us out. When we have cosine of square root of x, this is going to be 1, and then minus, put this here, we get x to the first power over 2 factorial, and then plus, put this here, we get x squared over 4 factorial, and then plus x to the third power over 6 factorial, and so on, so on, so on. Let's just be a minus right here. Great. But the problem now is, you see, everything here is plus, but here is alternating. So what do we do? Well, notice that this is x to the first power and x to the third power. In fact, all the odd power terms, they have the negative sign. That means we should plug in negative x right here, and we can fix that, because negative times negative is positive, of course. So let's write down cosine, but inside here, we write down square root with negative x. So we see this will produce 1, and then original is minus, and put a negative here, it becomes positive, everybody happy. And then we have the x over 2 factorial, same thing, but the negative square doesn't matter, so we still have this square over 4 factorial. And then, same thing here, it becomes minus, becomes plus now, x to the third power over 6 factorial. Very good. So, what does this mean? That means the original equation is nicely equal to cosine of square root of negative x. Let me just write that down. This is for that. And all we have to do is solve this equation being equal to 0. That's it. Very good. All right, now, cosine of what angle will give you 0? We have a lot of choices, right? But we are going to pick the smallest positive one. Why? Because we are looking for the biggest one, right? Notice that we have negative x later on. So the smallest for now, it will be the biggest later, after we divide both sides by negative. So I will choose this whole thing to end up with pi over 2, right? Then, from here, I will just square both sides and divide the negative on both sides, and we get x being equal to negative pi squared over 4. And this will give us the biggest answer for this equation here. Great, we did it, right? So, this is wonderful. Now, as promised, I will show you guys the non-real way, namely, we have to go to the complex root for it. Are you ready? Okay, good. So now, here's the deal. When you have cosine, you see this right here just alternates. In fact, you can invite a cosine of cosine, then in that case, you actually just get everything being adding already. And that cosine is the hyperbolic version of the cosine. And because I want the power to be this, I will just plug in square root for that. That's great. But anyway, here is the deal. When we have hyperbolic cosine, namely the cosh, if we just have x, this right here is actually just this, but you change everything to positive, so you have 1 plus x squared over 2 factorial, and then plus x to the fourth power over 4 factorial, and so on, so on, so on. And again, we just have to plug in square root of x right here, and that will give us exactly what we want. So this is 1 plus, and we just get x over 2 factorial, and then plus x squared over 4 factorial, and then plus x to the third power over 6 factorial, and so on, so on, so on. Just like this. And with that said, that means our original equation becomes cosh of square root of x being equal to 0. So let's just write that down. Cosh of square root of x, we have to make this equal to 0 now. I didn't expect this, huh? And this is actually kind of weird, you'll see. Now, how do we solve for cosh of something equal to 0? It's not so easy. You have to look at what the input is right here, which is square root of x, and recall the definition in the exponential form for cosine with the h. This right here will give us e, and you just enter whatever this is, which is square root of x, and then you add e, and this is negative square root of x, and then divided by 2, that's equal to 0, like this. And now this is so weird, because how can we have this plus that? Because this is always positive, and that's always positive. How can we have this plus that end up to be 0? I don't know, but I know. Have a look. Let me multiply both sides by 2, and let me bring this to the other side. So in another word, we see this is e to the square root of x being equal to negative, right? Negative e to the negative square root of x, like this. And one way to get rid of the situation right now is to take the natural log. So let's go ahead and do that. Natural log this, and natural log that. This is okay. Cancel right away. We end up with square root of x right away. Very good. However, as we discussed earlier, e to the whatever is always positive. Negative times always positive is always negative. Ln of a negative thing, this right here is actually a complex number. And this is how you are going to deal with this. First, this is like saying negative 1 times e to the that, right? So I will just break it apart as ln of negative 1 plus ln of e to the negative square root of x. Now, this and that can be canceled right away. That's good. Well, of course, we have to do it with caution. And the ln of negative 1, this is the trouble zone. In fact, I have done a video on this already. You will have to change this into the power form. And one way to show you is ln. Negative 1 can be famously written as e to the I pi power. Right? That's for negative 1. And you see this and that will cancel, and you just get negative, or you just get I pi. And again, I will have the video in the description where I talk more about that. And let me just write that down for you guys. We have square root of x now. That's equal to, we have this being just I pi, as I told you guys earlier, which is actually a complex number. And then here, after we cancel this out, this is just negative square root of x. Very good. And right here, this is actually just what we call the principal value for this. And this is in fact all we need. Because again, we're just trying to find the biggest solution, and you will see, right? Now, let me add this on both sides. So we actually have 2 square root of x equals I pi, divide both sides by 2, and then you will see square root of x is equal to I pi over 2. Well, is this going to give us negative value for x? Yes, you bet. Because if we square both sides, we see x is nicely equal to I squared, which is precisely negative 1. So we get negative, and then we have pi squared over 2 squared, of course, is 4. And this right here is the same as what we got earlier. Isn't this so cool, right? Yes. Are you impressed? Very impressed. All right. Now, is there any connection between this and that, though? What do you guys think? Yes, there is. Because if you notice, we have a negative 1 right here, instead of the square root. square root of negative 1 is what? You can just look at that, I, that's correct. So in fact, I would like to write this down right here for you guys. Whenever you have cosine, and if you have I times whatever, and let me just use theta right here, in fact, you will end up with just cosh of theta. See, when we had I right here, that will translate to the cosh function and the I disappear, but you actually you have to squeeze that back again. But again, right here, we didn't use any complex number. This is the real way to do it, and this is the non-real way to do it. Let me know which way that you guys like more, right? So that's it right here. Yeah. Okay, good. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you.